Cameron loves glizzies. He would do anything for a glizzy. He loves glizzies so much, he destroys glizzies.
This is
swallows in one big bite. Call him the Joey Chestnut of glizzies. He loves glizzies. I don't know what to tell you. All week he's been asking to get a glizzy. Just so he can chow down on it. Could even go a week without a glizzy. Look at him. Glizzy lover. Good. See this? One bite. You know the rules.
This is New York.
Okay. Alright. I don't know what that was about. Good.
We're having a ball here.
Hold up. Let me.
Still recording. Ready for this?
One bite. You know the rule. What's your ranking in? This nigga loves glizzies. That's what she just now said.
But it makes it more authentic, you know? Uh-huh. Those flowers are pretty right there.
I think it's one of those where it's like, I think, okay, so you know how we were talking about Nashville? We were talking about like other cities. And I said that with most cities, it feels like LA, it feels like you have to be part of the culture to get with it. I think, and we were talking about how like in New York at least, it feels like one of those where it's like, just don't get in my way type things. I feel like that's the type of energy and flow that,
do your thing.
Like in, yeah. I think that's exactly kind of the thing I'm talking about. Such a, after yesterday, I was like, it's just not worth it, you know what I mean?
Like, you already have the test.
Yeah.
So how did you get them so early?
I had to buy them, though. I had to buy them from StockX.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because they dropped at Adidas, right? Huh? Was it Lucas? I think Lucas posted about
I remember
on TikTok. But I woke up, when he posted about it, it was like the day before. I woke up, immediately went to Adidas, they were gone. Like, they were completely deleted from the site. So they shipped them out in one day. Everybody received them in one day. So I saw Vinny had them on, Lucas had them on. I saw everybody wearing them.
Yeah.
And I was like, dude.
I've not seen that many in Europe, or just in London right now.
Yeah. So I was like, I'm not even. I thought, okay, I'll wait it out. And then they dropped a raffle at some
store.
Yeah,
it was like a random site.
Yeah, and I was like, cool. So then I loaded it up. And I got two pairs.
Two?
Yeah. But then the crazy thing is, they canceled all the raffles because they're like, oh, it wasn't even supposed to be online. Yeah, so they canceled all the raffles, took everything back, canceled all the orders, and I was like, well, alright, it is what it is. So then I had to wait again, and then I didn't know when the release date was. It was supposed to be like early May, it was late May,
yeah, it was like,
June 4th.
It was a lot of like, days, yeah, it was like.
So then I was able to get a pair for like $270.
Thank you.
Jacket. Oh, the full sets that much?
What was this, the jacket series? The jacket was 280. I didn't look at the deal. I saw the picture. You didn't put up the picture and I was like, I should have seen that. Because that was like, because when we were walking past and I was like, oh shit, Supreme's over here. I was
thinking, oh, what does it say there? Two.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. It's light, right? That's light.
You're such a neighbor's kind of crazy.
Oh, you're good, dog.
You wanna see this one with the denim jeans?
If y'all have any questions, we'll try anything on. I got a fitting room. I got more shit downstairs, so just let me know.
All right, cool.
I'll just try it on.
Before I start the pickups, I'm sorry if I sound a bit stuffy. I've been dealing with a sinus infection all week while on vacation, so my apologies. First pickup, I thought we might as well start with shoes. While I was in New York, I linked up with Jimmy, and us as a combo is a very bad combo because all we do is spend money. And we walked into the Prada store planning not to buy anything, just to look around, and I made him a bet. I said, if you buy a pair of the Prada American Cups, then I'll buy a pair. And as you can see, now I'm left with these. He got the green colorway, which was really, really sick, but you know me. I had to go all black. I've been wearing them a ton. Somehow, I've already scuffed them. I don't even know how I did that. Next pair of shoes is a pair of Para boots. I've been really on like this fur kick recently. So I've been looking out for these Para boots. I believe they're called Michael and Derbies, where it almost kind of looks like Clark Wallaby, except it has like a platform sole, or just a Goodyear welted sole, and it's completely fur, but I think it's faux fur, but it's like this pony hair type thing, except it looks like a cowhide print. Super sick, really out there. I saw it and in my brain I knew it would like work in my wardrobe and like it would go with outfits. I did not think it would be like this versatile in my wardrobe where I'm basically wearing it with any and everything. I have absolutely not beat these up, but I've worn these for like a month straight. They became my favorite pair of shoes. These are sick. The details are crazy. The welting is absolutely ridiculous. The quality and the attention to detail is crazy. And the funnier part is like these normally go for like $600. I got these on sale, so they dropped down to like $400, and then they were doing a 40% off of that, so I got them for like $220. It was a steal, and super happy with it. These are cool. These are cool. It's cool sometimes to dress a little out there. You feel me? Get a little bit out of your comfort zone. Goodness, dude, my allergies. Next pickup is a pair of Art Legacy flat toe boots. I actually got these, funny enough, from Jacob Keller. Bought them off him. I've been really on this like boots and shorts trend, and I hate these with shorts. So, I mean, like they're still cool as like a normal boot. It kind of gives me like Bottega Veneta lean boot type vibes. So in that regard, they're super, super sick. But like as a boot to wear with shorts, they don't work. And realistically, I don't think boots and shorts works for me.
because my calves are just too big. So a lot of the time when you see like the shaft of the boot with like people who are doing the boots and like shorts thing, it's much wider, looser, but for me it like hugs my calf. So it doesn't really work the same, but these are super cool, very much Westerner, but different from a cowboy boot in a way. Definitely more of like engineer boot type vibe. So I like these. I think I'm gonna be wearing these a ton. Not much in the summer, but definitely it's gonna be like my winter pair of boots for sure. Now, next pickup deals with something very important in the summer for me, and that is a pair of loafers. So I've been a fan of Toca Varillas for ages, but I've never pulled the trigger. And Toca Pula, or I believe it's Toca Pula, is their women's line. And normally the highest they go up to is a 41 Italian, which is like a size 9 men's, I believe, or like an 8.5 men's. So I saw these like metal harness loafers that they've been doing for the longest, but it was different because it had the tassel, and the men's version doesn't have like a tassel loafer like that. So I decided to grab these, and they are snug. I'm not gonna lie to you, they are extremely snug, but I'm gonna make it work because they're just so sick. Like, I really like the metal detailing that comes with them. You don't really see that on anything else. And I don't, it's something about them that's like, it's extra enough to make it like fun and cool. So I'm not a real big loafers guy. I prefer derby. I feel like every single time I put on loafers, for like somebody's granddad. But this had enough edge to it where it's kind of different. And it's toga, so the quality of them is really, really nice. Can't really go wrong. So a cool summer, a summer shoe, realistically. And I got these on the Essence sale, so they it was a good price. So I had to grab them. Next pair of shoes was one that's been, you know, going a little viral on TikTok. It is the Wells Bonner Adidas Sambas in like this silver metallic colorway. And they come with like these gray ribbon laces, which for all the girls out there is a real nice touch. I like that. But I wanted the core black ones that came out years ago. Never was able to grab it, mostly because of the yarn like stitching they did for the three stripes. And I've been a big fan of what she's been doing with her Adidas collabs. Saw these and it was like right up my alley for like ugly, which was sick. It's like, it's so out there and so shocking that it's like cool. And I feel like that's just where I'm at this point with my fashion things. Like, if it's weird enough, I probably think it's cool. So with these, I've been beating these up clearly. As you can see, they're like completely creased and everything. But they kind of just go with everything. I almost treat them like how I would treat like a white pair of shoes and just kind of toss it on with anything and everything. The last pair of shoes is my holy grail of sneakers. If you guys don't know, I am a big fan, and I will ever be a big fan of Virgil Abloh. He's the guy who realistically got me into clothing, got me into streetwear, and what he did with LV was incredible in my opinion. So he convinced me to buy my first designer purchase, which was the LV trainers, but I got this black and white colorway, and I ended up selling it. I wasn't the biggest fan of the colorway, but he was the guy to get me to do it. And after I bought him, unfortunately, he had passed. But ever since then, I've been on the hunt for this specific colorway. And this specific colorway is the Spring Summer 21 Fragment colorway. It is my favorite pair of shoes to ever be made. I have always wanted them. The thing is, though, after his passing, the prices for them just continue to skyrocket, and I just can never get my hands on them. Luckily, I found a guy who had a pair used. They are kind of beat, I'm not gonna lie to you, but it was in my size, so I just had to like pull the trigger on them and grab them, and I don't regret it. It's my favorite shoe I've ever owned. It is my dream grail sneaker. It is the shoe that made me want to buy shoes and like buy sneakers like this. So I don't know what else to really say. You see it, you see what it is. It's just a dream shoe for me. I don't think anything will ever top this. So Spring Summer 21 LV Trainer, RIP Virgil. So that's on my shoe pickups. Let's start moving on to tops. First one, of course, it's another post-archive faction piece. I mean, at this point, I'm a brand ambassador. I just wear it all the time. It's their newest seams t-shirt, which it's like, it has this stitching that goes throughout the entire shirt and onto the back of the shirt. It's really, really sick. I mean, it's just a plain black tee with PAF across and just that stitching detail, but I've been wearing it for like a week straight. It's super soft, super comfy, and it has enough detailing where it's like, it's not just a plain black tee. So it's cool. Like, I like it. But at the end of the day, it is a black tee. So there's not too much I can say to describe it, but I really like it. And the fit's dope, so can't really beat it. Next pickup is a jersey I got from the Saturday's football pop-up event. I ended up getting two jerseys. I get a Welsh jersey, and I got this one here. For me, you know, I like black, and black jerseys, there's only so many ways you can look and have a black jersey. So when I saw this, I just thought it was kind of like out there enough where we're sick. Like, I really dig the cross that goes across. I mean, duh, for the Portugal badge. But I just thought it was a really sick jersey, and it wasn't for too bad of a price. So I decided to grab it. It has these like rubber shoulder type things. If someone could tell me what that's about or what that's for, I really appreciate it. But yeah, I went ahead and grabbed it. Just thought it was cool. Next pickup is the Vuja Day, I believe, from a t-shirt. It's the one from their most recent collection, and it has like this twist detailing that ends up actually matching the pants you wear, but I didn't buy the pants. I just got the t-shirt. And I'm not gonna lie to you, it is the best fitting and most comfortable white t-shirt I've bought. I saw the price tag and I kinda scuffed at it. I was like, there's not a chance I'm paying that much for a white t-shirt. Decided not to cop on release date. And then I saw Ken and DeMario make a video kind of showcasing off the t-shirt, and it convinced me to pick it up, and I'm actually quite happy with my purchase. So happy, in fact, that I hope they make a black one, and I don't think I would own any more black or white t-shirts. I think these would be my black and white t-shirts for the rest of my life. Not necessarily the rest of my life, but you get the concept. Like, I think they're super sick, and I hope this becomes like a staple piece that they consistently make, because it is super, super sick. But it is just a white tee, so like, the fact that I have this much to say about it is kind of crazy. So yeah, this one's sick, super, super sick. I love the word sick. Maybe it's because I'm sick that I'm saying the word sick so much. That's probably what it is. Yeah, think about it. Now we can move into like outerwear. The next two pickups were actually from a trade. I got it from my boy Chev, and I ended up getting this Acne Studios 2016 denim jacket. I have the pants to match, so I just thought as like a Canadian tuxedo type thing, it'd be sick. And then I added this like oversized safety pin, aka a diaper pin, onto it. And then I also got this module. It's a Korean brand, and funny enough, he saw this on my Pinterest saves. And this is what made us start the trade, which was hilarious to me. But it's like this chore jacket type thing, except it's completely made out of a canvas or a cotton twill. Super sick, re-zips all throughout. It's cool, I really like it. Both of these, I mean, you could say they're like technically free. Definitely more for the fall, winter, I feel. But yeah, you'll definitely see me rocking these later on. Dude, my sinuses are killing me. Let me tell you, the week I've had has been horrific. I couldn't move my jaw for a whole 3 days. I didn't talk for a whole day because my jaw was locked. And I was like, what is this? Is this my wisdom teeth that's causing me to do this? No, sinuses had drained into my jaw and decided to become inflamed. You can't make this up. You just can't make this up. Next pickup is this Needles flannel. I've bought like seven, no, that's an exaggeration. I've bought like three Needles flannels. Two of which have been the zipper ones, which the zipper ones are a cool concept, except when you wear them with just a t-shirt and you can feel the cold zipper on your skin, it's just irritating. But I really wanted it in like this brownish tan color, and I was finally able to grab one from a local store here in Nashville called Rooted. And Yeah, I've been wearing it ever since. It's cool. It's just one of their rebuild flannels that drop every blue moon. I don't know when they drop. They just happen to drop, and you kind of just have to be there to grab it. But yeah, it's cool. It's funny. We went to New York. I let Tariq wear it, and the man got more compliments on his fit than I did the whole trip. Everybody was talking about his needles flannel, and he was like, man, what is this flannel? Because he was talking about how many compliments he was getting. So it's cool, man. It's cool. Next pickup is one I also got while I was in New York. This is what I got from Luke's. It's that CDG Home Plus button down, and it's the one that has like all this like hardware hits on the back here and on the front. I just, for that alone, I thought it was sick. Like, I like these blue striped button-ups, but they kind of just get boring when you have it being these simple blue white striped button-ups. So the hardware detailing was like really cool in my opinion, to kind of like add something to it. And it fits me great. Like, I feel like you could wear a tank underneath this, and it's a cool like summer spring outfit, or you can kind of dress it up like how it's supposed to be worn. You can dress it down. There's a lot of variations with it, so it'll be a staple in my closet for sure. Last top is one that I got off the Real. It's actually vintage Celine. However, it is women's, of course, with Phoebe Philo. But I just really like this like sky blue, like baby blue color. And it's just a plain button up, but it's made from polyester, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. It's either 100% polyester or viscose. I can't remember. But it's super sick. It's slightly see-through. It's great for the summer. I just roll up the sleeves on it and throw it on with like a pair of white pants, and I call it a day. The only thing that irritates me is the fact that with all women's like bun downs, the buns are on the opposite side, which I don't really understand why, to be honest. Why is it like that with a lot of female items that like all the zippers, buttons are swapped? If someone could tell me in the comments below, please do. But yeah, just vintage Celine button down. Cool. Lastly, we got bottoms. And here we have these Peter Doe denim that I believe was from spring summer 21, if I'm not mistaken. But it's another pair of like women denim. Peter Doe is now starting to do menswear, but he only did womenswear for the longest. And I just really needed some white jeans, if I'm being real with you. And these are kind of like pleated and baggy, high rise. It kind of just went right up my alley. But like I said earlier, it's one of those where all the features on it, all the zippers and buttons are on the opposite side, so that kind of throws you. But other than that, it fits like any other pair of jeans. It's just a closet staple, you know, just a pair of white, or these are more of like an off-white color pair of jeans. Next pair of bottoms is another one I got from New York. We went to the Supreme store, and the one thing I was talking about I wanted was a pair of raw baggy denim. I love raw denim, but sometimes that straight leg just makes you feel like a heritage man and you want to be a lumberjack. So the baggy fit gives me much more of a casual laid back vibe. I went true to size, and the waist really fits like a size 32. And these are definitely baggy. Have that Supreme hit on the back there. These are cool, man. I really like these. I wore this, once I picked these up, I wore this for the whole trip. For the remainder of the trip, I wore it every single day. Super cool. I can't wait to beat these up and kind of see what they turn into over time. You know, some people tell you Supreme is dead, but I would disagree, especially Supreme bottoms. The pants be hidden, bro. All right, we're almost done. The last few pickups are short. I'm gonna do a rapid fire so we can kind of get this over with, because this video is getting way, way too long. So first one is another pair of raw denim. It's Stussy's big old jean jorts. I haven't worn these, but I kind of just want to experiment with them and kind of get into the jorts thing. Size 30. I really say you can go true to size with these, especially if you're a bigger thigh guy like me and you got those thunder thighs. These fit fine. So these are cool. Last pair of shorts is the Arc'teryx Gamma LT lightweight shorts. These are my alternatives to the Patagonia baggies. Not that they're cheaper, they're more expensive, But they're cooler and they're better, in my opinion. And baggier. So these are the 9-inch ones. Super sick. Just a summer nylon short. You can't go wrong with it. But yeah, that's all my pickups from New York and from the last couple of months. So I hope you guys enjoyed the vlog and the pickups. But anyway, if you liked the video, leave it a like, subscribe if you want. But that's all. All right, bye.
Look at this dude.
We got paparazzi, gang.
You know the rules. One bite.
Oh, yeah.
7-3.
Interviewing Julie.
I think I should interview you.
Seem to be confused. He's not talking to me. The boy is mine.